So Sam.
Little S, big A, little M. What up, Brendanovich?
I wasn't feeling so well, so I was off to see the evolutionist.
I'm sorry, what?
Yeah, I am seeing an evolutionary medicine practitioner now.
Of course you are. And how's that working out for you?
You know, they're still kind of researching the field, so I think it's gonna be a while before I can get a lot of help with my evolutionary ailments.
Evolutionary ailments.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
So I was reading about University of Zurich has opened their Center for Evolutionary Medicine.
Oh, well, that's cool. So we're getting, seems slightly more real now. Uh-huh.
Yeah, and they said that they look at two different ways evolution can be useful to the study of medicine.
Cool, and those two ways are?
Changes in the human anatomy.
Mm-hmm.
And genetic changes in the pathogens that cause diseases for us.
Oh goodness, I bet you have examples.
I have examples.
Scientific station, we've got examples. Oh gosh.
So, for with human anatomy, it is assumed, or it is being studied, that our more sedentary lifestyle that humans have now.
That darn sedentary lifestyle.
We sit around a lot more than our ancestors did.
True, very true.
So, they are studying our spines to see if maybe we have weaker spines because of our sedentary lifestyle, and that makes us more prone for lower back pain.
That sounds pretty logical to me.
I think
pretty,
it is.
Pretty logical. I don't know. What about the other example?
The other example is going to ancient human remains.
Getting cool.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Mummies from Egypt.
Oh, cool level is getting raised right now.
Dead bodies from Irish bogs.
A little bit lower on the cool level. Bogs, gross. Uh-huh.
Frozen cavemen.
Oh my gosh,
in
we
glaciers.
Just hit awesome level of cool. So?
So, at the Center for Evolutionary Medicine, they can take tissue samples from these bodies, and they can find the pathogens that cause disease for us now on the ancient bodies that they find, and they can genetically sequence them to see how those organisms that make us sick now changed from then to now.
Okay, so we're comparing ancient disease DNA to modern disease DNA?
Yeah, ADD to MDD.
Well, ain't that nifty. Cool. That sounds actually intelligent, actually.
Kind of.
Go see your evolutionist.
I'm going to go
see
my evolutionist.
Tell me how that works out.
Yeah.
It might take a little while, you know, evolution.
Maybe a little bit.
That was an evolution joke. I don't know if people caught that.
It took me a bit.
Ha!
I think I evolved to the point where I got
gosh.
It. Oh,
gosh. Oh, so funny. Anyway.
If they have any comments, questions.
Or concerns, just send them our way at scientificstation.com.